Hello children, welcome back to another online class. Hope you will have good time today. Okay, we learnt about two major ancient civilizations in the previous class. Can you name them? Yes, they are Egyptian civilization and Mesopotamian civilization. Before we get into today's class lesson, let's have a quick recap of what we learnt about these two civilizations. Egyptian civilization, we saw that they developed a solar calendar system, the pyramids, hieroglyphic way of writing system, mummies, that is the preservation of human body, and how they applied innovation in the use of science and technology. About Mesopotamian civilization, we saw about the invention of potter's wheel, development in the calendar system, their system of writing called cuneiform, and an important legal document called Hammurabi's Code.
As we are going to study about Chinese civilization, why don't we know about Great Wall of China, which is one of the man-made wonders? The average height of the wall is 6 to 7 meters. The Great Wall is about 2,700 years old. More than 10 lakhs laborers were involved in construction of this huge project. As a must-see in China, it attracts 50 million visitors every year.
Okay, in today's class, we are going to see about the Chinese civilization and the Indus Valley civilization. China is recognized as one of the four great ancient civilizations of the world, together with ancient Egypt, Mesopotamian civilization, and Indus. It is the only ancient civilization that has continued to this very day. China has two major rivers. One is known as Huanghe, and the other is called Yangtze River. In the Far East, a great river valley civilization flourished on the banks of river Huanghe. It is also called Yellow River since the soil around is yellow in color. The Yellow River is also known as the Sorrow of China. It is called so because it changed its course and caused frequent floods. This resulted in destruction of crops and canals. This region is regarded as the cradle of Chinese civilization. It was here that the earliest Chinese dynasties were based. And it was from here that Chinese civilization spread out across the rest of China. Neolithic communities lived in China between 4500 and 3750 BC. As we all know, Neolithic denotes a new stone age. The Henan province in the Yellow River Valley contain evidence of Neolithic villages. The city-states of China gradually became part of the empire. Okay, now we are going to look into the two important dynasties, the Qin dynasty. It was the first dynasty of China. This dynasty was founded by Qin Shi Huang. He is considered to be the first emperor of China. He had the title Son of Heaven. The period between 221 and 206 BC is known as the Imperial Era in China. The emperor defeated feudal lords and established a strong empire. He has the credit of unifying China. He destroyed the walled fortification of different states. And one of the wonders of the world, the Great Wall of China, was constructed during his period. He built this to protect the empire from the invading nomadic people. He built roads to integrate, that is to join his empire. The other one is the Han Empire. Han dynasty ruled China from 206 to 220 AD. The Han dynasty was the second imperial dynasty of China. The Han period is considered to be a golden age in Chinese history. Much of Chinese culture was established during Han Empire. The greatest of the Han emperors was Emperor Wu Ti. He expanded the empire and built many irrigation tanks. He sent Zhang Quan as emissary or diplomat to the West, and this paved way for the opening of the Silk Road in 130 BC. He built this in order to encourage trade activities. Since silk was the major trade which traveled on the road, it was named the Silk Road. China benefited immensely during the rule of Emperor Zhang because of the Silk Road. Chinese silk had great demand in Roman Empire. Chinese silk was much sought after during the time of Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius. The Chinese silk reached Rome through the ports of Tamaragam. We are going to see about the philosophy and literature during the Chinese civilization. There were Chinese poets and philosophers like Lao Tzu, Confucius, Mencius, Moti, and Tao Chien contributed to the development of Chinese civilization. Let's have a look at some of the literary works and the philosophers. Sun Tzu, a military strategist, wrote the work called Art of War. The Yellow Emperor's Canon of Medicine is the book on medicine. Lao Tzu, the founder of Taoism, argued that desire is the root cause of all evil. Confucius was the famous Chinese philosopher. He was a political reformer. His name means the master. He insisted on cultivation of one's own personal life. He said, if personal life is cultivated, family life is regulated. And once family life is regulated, national life regulated. Mencius was another major Chinese philosopher and offered his counsel to the rulers. Chinese script, the ancient writing system, was pictographic, meaning each symbol represented a physical object. This was later converted into a symbol form. Let's summarize the contribution of the Chinese civilization. The writing system was improved, invention of paper, opening of the Silk Road, and invention of gunpowder. Alright, now we are going to see about the Indus civilization. The Indus civilization was the earliest known urban culture. The other name of Indus civilization are Indus Valley civilization or Harappan civilization. The Indus Valley civilization was an ancient civilization located in what is Pakistan and northwest India today, on the fertile floodplain of the Indus River. The major cities of the Indus civilization are Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Kalibangan, Lothal, Banavali, and Rakhigari. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro were the archaeological sites in Punjab, Pakistan. These cities are well known for their impressive, organized, and regular layout. Drainages can be observed in the Harappan towns. In constructions, Harappans used baked, unbaked bricks and stones for construction. The Great Bath of Mohenjo-daro is the earliest public water tank in the ancient world. It was an important structure used for special religious functions. Some unearthed structure have been identified as the granary. Nature of the state or political organization of the Harappan was unknown. A male image of Mohenjo-daro has been identified as priest king. Agriculture was the main occupation of the Indus people. The crops raised by them are wheat, barley, and millets. They domesticated animals like cattle, sheep, and goats. The Harappan cattle are called zebu, and it is a large breed often represented in Harappan seals. Harappans used painted pottery. They used deep red slip and black paintings. They used slip to create images. Different designs were painted on pottery like pipal tree, leaves, fish scale designs, geometrical motifs, and floral and faunal patterns. Harappans used shirt blades, copper objects, bone, and ivory tools. They used tools such as chisels, needles, fish hooks, razors, weighing pans, and mirror. They used weapons like arrows, spears, a chisel, a bladed tool, axe, and a rare and unique masterpiece found on the Indus site was a bronze image of a dancing girl made using a lost wax process or molten metal. The Harappans used ornaments made of metal and stone. They also used cotton and silk textiles. They had close trade links with the Mesopotamians. Harappan seals have been found in the West Asian sites, namely Oman, Bahrain, Iraq, and Iran. They developed a system of proper weights, measures. Since they were engaged in commercial transactions, copper plates for weighing balances were formed there. The Indus people worship nature. They worship pipal tree, fire altars used for sacrifice have been found at Kalibangan. The Indus civilization had mixed population. Several groups, including farmers, pastoralists, and hunter-gatherers lived in the Indus region. Finally, the Indus culture had to see the decline. The Indus civilization started declining from about 1900 BC. The reasons could be the change in climate, decline the trade with Mesopotamia, and drying up or flooding of the river Indus. Invasion of tribes people from the hills to the west of the Indus Valley. And the other reason could be migration of people in the southern and eastern directions. In spite of this, Indus culture did not completely disappear, but continued as rural culture. Children, I hope you enjoyed today's class. And for better understanding, read pages 23 to 28. And don't forget to play a Kahoot. Thank you, children.